Today we're going to talk about creating timelines in project, and I'm just going to dive in here and get started here. Okay, I'm going to turn this Gantt chart here into a timeline like this one here, okay? And this is good because then you can communicate to people what's going on when, right? So for example, we'll use milestones here to tell you when the end of planning happens, okay? We'll use another milestone over here for project complete. Okay, we'll also use some summary tasks to show phases in the timeline. This is good when you want to communicate to stakeholders, okay, this is what's happening when. Because a lot of times they don't have project. And if you emailed them a link to the file or an attachment, they'd sort of say, well, what is this? I don't understand this. So let's show you how to make this timeline. I'm going to go into project here. And here's our Gantt chart. We've been using this in previous webinars if you've been attending the project webinars or watching our YouTube videos. We've made a Gantt chart here that is all about planning and holding the company party, okay? It's a relatively simple example. There are, you know, much more complicated projects out there, but for people that are learning this application from scratch, this is a good one to start with. First thing we need to do to make this Gantt chart timeline ready is we need to add a few things here. We're going to add, first of all, some milestones, okay? Let's first define what a milestone is. And this is just a definition from Wikipedia. A milestone is an event that receives special attention, okay? It is often put at the end of a stage to mark the completion of a work package or phase, okay? What does that mean? Well, it's helpful to have some examples. Training complete would be a perfect example of a milestone, right? Let's say a new system's rolling out at your company and you need to train the accounting department on January 1st, the sales department on January 15th, the receptionists on the 30th, and so forth and so on. And when everyone's done, there's a milestone at the end there that says training complete, right? Here's some other examples. Testing complete, if you needed to test a system, run a bunch of test passes and then say, okay, we're done. Testing is complete. That would be a milestone. Production complete, that's fairly self-explanatory if you're producing something. Annual report complete, maybe you have a phase that's, you know, writing, another task that's editing, another task that's revising, and printing, publishing, etc. And then you say annual report complete, okay? Confirmed decision to proceed is a common example. Like, for example, if you we're doing a business plan or doing some research and you had a bunch of tasks related to research, you know, research demographics, research audience, et cetera, et cetera. And then a milestone, confirm decision to proceed. And you would answer that yes or no and proceed or not proceed. And then the most common generic milestone you'll see out there is project complete. It's the one at the end, very end of the project. It just says project complete. Okay. Milestones are signified by diamonds in the project management Gantt chart. And we're just going to go ahead and insert a milestone at the end of this project. It's pretty self-explanatory. You just go up here to task, and then you click milestone, all right? And what it does, it just inserts a task with 0 days duration, right? A milestone, just it doesn't have any work associated with it. It's just a marker saying, this is a significant day. This is the end of this phase, okay? So we'll go ahead and say project complete here, 0 days. And we're gonna make this auto-scheduled. If you saw the previous videos, you'll see what I'm talking about. And we're gonna link these two tasks together here, okay? We've been linking using this link button, but I might as well show you the keyboard shortcut now that we've done this a few times. Control F2 links those together, and now that milestone project is over here on the right at the end of the project on July 17th, okay? There's that diamond. Let's insert another milestone in the middle of these tasks, okay? Because they're not always at the end. You know, they're often in the middle. And you often need to put them in the middle of a bunch of tasks because you didn't plan ahead and know where the milestone would be. So for example, right here, I've got a bunch of planning tasks. I'm brainstorming, I'm improving ideas, I'm drafting the budget, okay, approving the budget. I'm doing a lot of desk work here or sort of thought work. I'm not I'm not really implementing anything yet. I'm not spending money. I'm not hiring people or hiring resources, etc. So I'm going to put a new milestone here, okay? And I'm going to say this is end of planning, okay? And again, it's 0 days. There's no work assigned to it. It's just a marker in the schedule. I'm going to make that auto schedule, okay? And then I'm going to link that to the previous task, okay? Now we have to do a little bit of link cleanup here because ideally we want this task to be linked to the subsequent ones, okay? And in the previous webinar, we linked all these three tasks to this one here, boss approving the budget. And you can see that there are these three arrows that are extending from Sheila's approving of the budget to the subsequent ones here, okay? And one way you can do that is you can go up to the unlink button and unlink that, okay? And then you can relink by first selecting the milestone and then holding down the control key and selecting the next task and then linking them that way. And now the milestone is linked to the next task. If you have to do this, I have to do this two more times because these other tasks happen in parallel. One quick way to do that is look over here at the predecessor column, okay? Right now, the hire caterer task is linked to the boss approving the budget. See, here's the four and here's the four. That's that mapping there, okay? You can just change it real quickly by changing the predecessor to five and then hitting return, and then that arrow changes from milestone to task, okay? And I'll do that again here. So rent some equipment right now is linked to four. That's task four right here, boss approving of the budget. We need this to be linked to end of planning, so we'll just use the five as the predecessor. Okay, and now we have a nice clean cascading of tasks to the milestone and then the milestone linking to the subsequent tasks. Okay, so that's inserting milestones. That's something, you know, you'll definitely want to do. If you think, oh, I just want to enter tasks and not worry about this 0 days stuff, no, you'll need to use milestones, and I'll show you why in that timeline in just a second. So now let's insert some summary tasks, okay? Summary tasks are also called roll-up tasks, where they contain other tasks or subtasks within them. They're good for phases, for marking phases in your timeline. So we talked about these being these planning tasks. Let's insert a summary task here that contains those, and we'll call that the planning phase, okay? And what it does is it indents the subtasks underneath this main task here, this summary task. And then here's your summary bar over here on the right. And you can expand and collapse that as you need to, okay? It's also just, it makes it nice and readable. You can, and if you needed to, you could collapse these so that you could concentrate on other tasks, which is nice. But what that summary task button does is it just simply indents the tasks you selected and adds a new one at the top. It also sums up the duration underneath that for the containing tasks. And we'll do that again here. Let's do it the long way just to show you what project's doing. I'm gonna right click and say insert task, and I'm gonna call this implementation phase, okay? And I'm gonna make sure that task is all the way to the left and indented or outdented as much as possible. And then I'll indent these guys here, okay? And that's all that project's doing, is making a new task and indenting or outdenting as necessary, okay? So these are our summary tasks, planning phase and implementation phase, and the tasks inside those are subtasks. That's what project calls them, okay? Now we have the fun part. Now we get to make that timeline, something visual for people to see. So we'll go up to view and we'll make sure timeline's on, okay? And it adds this pane up here, this timeline, ready to have tasks added to it. And what you do is if you wanna add something to the timeline, you just right click it and choose add to timeline, okay? And here we go, we've got that planning phase added to the timeline, looks great. Again, if you wanted to add something, you just right click it add to timeline. And it adds your milestone right there to the timeline. Right click, add to timeline, okay? Another way to do this, if you wanted to, is you could drag and drop, okay? Drag and drop this whole summary up here, drag it up here, and add it to the timeline, okay? Now you got all those tasks. You can see what's happening when. That's probably overkill for what I'm trying to do. Often a timeline's nice if you just need a quick snapshot for a bunch of people. Maybe the snapshot's for people that aren't directly involved, but they just want to know in general when things are going to happen. So I'm going to delete a few of these. I'm going to delete this guy here, delete this one. I'm just selecting the task and hitting the delete key. Okay. And you don't have, you're not stuck with all this. You can definitely select a task and then drag it out, okay? And move the call out boxes as you need to. So don't feel like if you can't, if this was in here still, you're not stuck with hold Wednesday. That makes no sense, right? So you need to drag that guy out, make it a call out on the timeline, and now you can see when the event's being held, okay? You can also go in here and you can color code. Okay, I'm gonna do that here. I'll make this yellow and this green. And then that's pretty much it. That's pretty much a timeline, okay? Now, if you wanted to get this out in email, it's really easily. First of all, make sure to get the timeline tools, make sure you click in this pane here and you'll get the timeline tools tab up here. Click that guy. And then copy timeline. You got three choices. Emails, a small version of it. Presentations, a medium version. Full size is the full darn size of that timeline there. I'll show you what email looks like. Go ahead and go into email here. Paste. Okay, it makes a small version of it. You're not stuck with it. You can size it up if you need to. Okay, it is a vector graphic. It's not pixels. I mean, well, it is eventually when it's displayed on your screen, but to Outlook, it's still a vector-based object, meaning you can scale it and not lose quality, okay? Let's show the presentation option here. Go ahead and put this in. This was the finished product here. I'll delete that and do a paste. Move this guy down. I like to drag until you get that center guideline there, so it's centered on the PowerPoint slide. And then I do a control shift resize here so that I can proportionally resize from the center point of the slide. And I'm gonna let go here. And there you go, we've got a nice timeline of our project, okay? So that's a very simple introduction to timelines and project. There's a lot more to learn, so head on up there to our blog post, aka.ms/project3. There's more links and resources there for you. And then, of course, our general blog post page for Office Webinars is aka.ms/offweb, and you're going to see there a calendar of all our topics, a downloadable Outlook reminder, and all sorts of good stuff. So head on up there if you haven't seen it yet. Next week, come back because we're going to talk about getting your business started with Office 365. A lot of people, a lot of businesses are saving a ton of money by getting on the cloud. And if you're one of those businesses that like to do that, I encourage you to come back because Doug Thomas is going to talk about that next week on Tuesday. And thanks to the Office webinar team today. And we will see you during the Q&A. Thanks.